who's still there outside Wits University's main entrance. Abiwe?
That's the number I have.
Yes, and ironically, moments before we saw the chaos that we saw here where the students were dispersed by the SAPS, we were having a conversation with the deputy president of the SRC at Wits University, Stembiso Tobula. Stembiso, thank you for joining us once more. You saw what happened. Your reaction just on that?
I'm disappointed at the state. I'm really disappointed because at this point, I even showed people at home to say, look at them. They are sitting down with their hands up. They're literally sitting down. Just because their tires here doesn't mean they must shoot. Do you understand? There was nothing. We were not throwing stones. We were not throwing bricks at them. As I was taking an interview, students decided to sit and pull their hands up. And there's nothing that really they've done. So why?
And being fair, though, that happened only because the police were coming. Earlier on, we saw scenes of tires being burnt and the police being thrown away.
In them sitting down, it's them surrendering. They might have done things prior to that, but when they shot, they were not doing anything. They were sitting down. That's what matters. Do you understand?
What approach then can be had by protesters and your student side of things to keep things calm? Because we saw a car essentially being damaged even.
One thing I can tell you is that a student consists of different characters. That one we cannot handle. But the cause that we are fighting for is one, which is financial exclusion. And if students are going to gather to fight for financial exclusion, there's nothing we can do. Because everything could have been handled in control. We had 8 meetings with SET, the senior executive team. They could have handled this very easy by responding to our demands. But now we've taken this to the street. We started on Thursday protesting, but still today they haven't said anything. They still want to negotiate, yet they know after 8 meetings, they know our concessions, they know our demands. They should just respond.
Then what's the plan in terms of your student leadership at Wits University, and also if you have the national picture as to what's going to happen in other universities?
Other universities are going to take the same mandate because we are being disappointed by NSFAS. NSFAS is defunding every student around the world, and we are all facing financial exclusion. We were led by the University of Western Cape, by them clearing all their debts. Why is Zevlon not doing that? Because he should be doing it. If other universities can do it, he surely can do it. We were all affected by COVID. All our parents lost jobs. Do you understand? At this point, businesses lost business and they defunded students with their bursaries. So everyone was affected by COVID. So financial exclusion shouldn't be a thing. We call for fees must fall, and the response we got from the government is that no, NSFAS is going to be a bursary. Yet it means that it's not really a step towards the realization of free education, because one, they need to qualify for it. Two, they can be defunded at any point in time. Three, they can't even further their studies using NSFAS. Now NSFAS is saying they are not even sure that they can fund first year students. It means that we'll forever face financial exclusion. That's what it really means.
I just want to find a better understanding of what's going to happen then on the ground. Wits University went online on Monday, lectures resuming online, but you having a shutdown outside that. What's your plan then, essentially? Even are you going to try to stop the online lectures?
If we can, we will. If we can, we will. But one thing is to get the message across, is to not only halt learning. Do you understand? If our point is across even now, if Zevlon can see what's happening on the ground and responds with the demands we want, then we are not going to stop anything. We are only stopping this because we are frustrated students. Students are not registered. Do you understand? At this point, no one is ready for the academic year to continue. But they are continuing because mainly they are selfish. Their agenda is only money, and they are commercializing education.
Thank you very much, Stembiso Tabula, the deputy president of the SRC at Wits University, a lady that we were speaking to just moments before the chaos ensued here at Empire Road, where we saw a stun grenade being fired by the police, and then a hail of rubber bullets following through Sahan.
All right, Adire, stand by.